Everyone, welcome to Tianjin University Ambassador Webinar. We are going to discuss today about CSE scholarship. Now, this is the first webinar in April. Now, of course, we are not holding it at 1 April because it's April Fools. You would think there is no webinar today, but we are going to discuss today about study environmental science with CSE scholarship. Now, of course, we have invited one of our speakers that has been experienced for her undergraduate and master's study in Tianjin University, and also won the awardee as CSE scholarship awardee. Please welcome Kak Kezia Murli. Hello, Kak. Yeah.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Hello, Kiran. Hello, Timothy. Thank you for inviting me for in this webinar. Today, I will sharing my experience about my major in environmental science, either in bachelor or in master also. And also, I will explain my experience when I apply my major with Chinese government scholarship. Okay, let me share my 14.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
It's okay now?
Yes.
Okay. Wait. Okay. First of all, my name Kezia. I took my bachelor and master in Tianjin University. My bachelor I entered in 2017 and master last year, because I just graduated from my bachelor degree. And for master and bachelor, I got Chinese government scholarship, full scholarship. Okay. Now, next, I will explain what the benefit when you guys choose Chinese government scholarship. First, of course, you will be get the free tuition fees from until you graduate from first year until fourth year, or maybe if you in master degree, maybe until third year, like that. And of all, is it a full scholarship? Also, free university dormitory or an accommodation subsidy. It means when if now it's online, still online study, but when you in when we can going back to China, especially in Tianjin University, we will got the free dormitory, and also we got the stipend. For undergraduate, we got 2,500 per month, and for master, we got 3,000 per month, and for doctor, we got 3,500 per month. Also, for of course, when you study abroad, we must be have a medical insurance, and for a person per year, we have to pay 800 RMB, but for because the Chinese government scholarship, we got free for it. And also if for program lasting less than for program some program like Chinese language maybe less than 6 months, we have to buy and we have to pay 400 RMB for per person, but because of Chinese government scholarship it will be free. Okay, next, what document needed for under for Chinese government scholarship? Of course, I will explain for my undergraduate student first, because last year I just graduate. First of all, need original high school diploma or original notarius diploma. But if you guys still not graduate, for example, if you still in fourth year, maybe seventh semester for you guys in undergraduate degree, you can apply for pre-graduation certificate from your school to apply in Tianjin University. But if you guys also still in high school, maybe in Indonesian school, in you still in first semester, you can apply for pre-graduation certificate to when a pre-graduation certificate, because like in sixth semester you will graduate. And second, we need to high school academic transcript. It means you need to, because like when we got high school, we have we have score each, like the high school we have a some score that you need to transcript it and become in English or in Chinese. Also, of course, when you want to study abroad, we need to put the our passport with the validity period, and we need to Chinese or English proficiency. So in Tianjin University, we offer Chinese talk and English talk, and of course in Chinese, I'm taking in Chinese talk. So I prepare for SSK, and SSK we need to SSK 5 for business, law, liberal arts. Need SSK 5. But if you in science or engineering, only SSK 4 is enough. And the score for SSK 4 is 195, and for SSK 5 minimal score is 180. And the 5, you need to study experience resume. So this is you need to our school have a certain template for this experience resume. So for experience resume, the start education experience is should be start from senior high school, of course. And you need to I advise that for this study experience resume, you have to put your your activity when you high school, not just study in high school, right? You have to put your awardee, your activity, like maybe you join some competition, or maybe some business, or maybe you work have a part time there. You put all, and this is it will be have a plus point for you. Okay, next, personal things is a personal statement or study plan. For undergraduate degree, it's not too much. Only 6 words at least. It's not too much. Maybe it's 2 or 3 paragraph, and you put all your. I advise for this personal statement or study plan. You put all your why you choose Tianjin University, why you choose your major, why China, like that. All the simple like that, because it's undergraduate student. And for 7, you need to put the foreign physical examination form. For this point, China have a certain form for this. Not just you go to the hospital and I want to medical checkup, not like that. But we have a certain template for foreign physical examination form, and all this form will be already put on the our website in www.tgu.edu.cn. And or if you want to find it, you can ask me or Timothy directly. We will give you also in 8 for this is this. Number 8, applicants who are not in China must submit a scan of photocopy or visa transfer certificate from present school. This is only who you are in China, but you are in outside China is not it. For number 9, applicants who are not China or at present must submit scan certificate on criminal record. Okay, for this is in each country have a different certificate maybe, but yeah, make sure you maybe can go to police office, then you said that you need to certificate non-criminal records. And for Indonesia student, you can go to I can say Sipolda. You can say that you need you can say SKCK, but and it means certificate non-criminal records. And for other attachment, okay. Other attachment, they said applicant for architectural major are requested to submit 5 sketch of the applicant's own works. This is only for architectural major. Others is not. It's not that's not requirement. For number 10, also self-finance or Tianjin University scholarship applicants shall provide certificate bank saving or income certificate of financial guarantor. So for CGS, this point self-finance is not. This is not compulsory, okay. But for others than a Chinese government scholarship, it's compulsory. Either like Tianjin government scholarship, Tianjin University international scholarship, it's a compulsory. It's really important. Also, who applicants are still under age 18 or as September 1st, 2022, must submit the original guardian certificate. So, but this is, we are still online study, right? So who you are in still under 18 as of September 1st, 2022, you don't need, but once we need to going back to Tianjin University, you have to, and you still under 18, you have to apply this Guardian certificate. Also, I suggest for this point, certificate of award. Okay, for certificate of award, this is maybe in your in 3 years, your school, in high school, you have to maybe more active, not become passive student. I suggest because you need to make some doing competition like Timothy. Yeah, you know, Timothy have a lot of already, you know, and maybe you can, if you don't have join any competition, maybe you can find some activity like with social activity with, you know, that from in outside from your school, it's really good. Okay. And next, document needed for master student. Okay, who you are want to apply for master student? Because last year I also applied for master degree. And what this is not have a big difference with undergraduate document. First, we still need a highest diploma or pre-graduation certificate is required, because like this is the point. I already said before, when you still in seventh semester and you want to apply for next year, after you graduate, and you can apply from your university, previous university, that you need a pre-graduation certificate. Means the expectation when you will graduate, only like that. Okay, for number two, it's same academic transcript. For number three also, you need put your photocopy passport with validity period. Okay, not still, not if you want to apply, you know, validity period. And for number four, Chinese or English proficiencies, of course. This is where, like same, you need, if you want to apply with Chinese TOEFL, you need to apply SSK. And for English proficiency, of course, you need to apply English, like IELTS or TOEFL. And for study experience resume, this is for master students, study experience resume, you have to, like, not just in high school, but you have to make some activity more, like you have a 4 years or maybe 3 years when you doing your bachelor degree, right? So I suggest when you still in first year in your university now, you have to more active, not just study in university. Like me before, I'm only study, but only just join some competition like that. So maybe you can from not need too much too big competition. Maybe from your school have some small competition, you just join it. It means you have a social life there. And also in number six, study or research plan. Okay, for this is this point. In when you apply master, of course you have to think your what's your one to research in when you already become a master student, because in master there's not too much class in there, but we have a lot of time with the research, because in university we have highly competitive for like when you want to graduate, it's not difficult, but you have to fight for it, because in Tsinghua University we have a good reputation university, so you have to like more deep what you want to research in your research plan or study plan. For example, you first of all you can start from your background, your awardee, or what's your activity before when you grade when you bachelor degree, and then in second page you can start your why you choose TNT and why you like what's your interest with research plan, why you really interested with that topic. You have to give a big reason of that, and then I suggest you have to have one professor become as your supervisor, and you have to like reason why you choose that professor like that. That's a really detail. Also, why you the last you have to write your why you want to study in China, your attitude, before like that, and then you have really big in the future, what you wanna do in the future after you graduate from master in Tianjin University like that, because master I think is more a little difficult when you write your research plan. Okay, next it's same. This is for master student. You need to apply two recommendation letter in English or Chinese from two professor or associate professor. Okay, this is I will give the quick download to template because we have a certain template for that. Also for if this is number 8, it's not compulsory for master student, but for PhD applicants compulsory that you have a published paper or formal acceptance notification. And number 6, Tianjin University need form of professional acceptance of international student by Tianjin University professor. So this is you need to contact your professor, become your supervisor in Tianjin University, and then you ask him or ask her, can I become your student? I mean because I want to choose you as my supervisor, and you have to give some reason why you choose him, why you choose her, and what's your planning in the future, what's your research like that. Okay, in number 10, photocopy of Renner physical examination form. Okay, for this is it's same like when you apply in bachelor degree, it's same. And also number 11 also same, applicants who are in China must be submit scan photocopy visa and transfer. But if you are in China, it's not it. And number 12 is scan of non-criminal record. It's compulsory. If you from outside in China, it's compulsory. Like maybe each country has different non-criminal records, and you can go to the police office. And number 13, other attachment. A scholarship applicant should submit CSC application form with signature. Applicant school of architecture request submit from your okay. This is number 13. I will explain this. If you apply with Chinese government scholarship, we have to visit first the Chinese government scholarship website, and then after that after you put all your documents, and then you submit it, and then you will have one document that means you already register with Chinese government scholarship, and then you can download it, save it, become PDF, and then you put in our website in Tianjin University website that you will apply in. Our website is ISSS like that. Okay, and for architecture major you have to submit the e-work, like your collection work like that. Okay, your video presentation. Okay, next for how to apply. Okay, this is the important part. Maybe if you want to apply for type A, because CGS have type A, B, and C. And type A, one of them is bilateral CGS bilateral program. Okay, for those who student want to apply with type A, especially for undergraduate degree program, you need to apply with type A. And first, you need apply the CGS type A through our website, CGS website. This is website. And after you register, and then after you put all your documents, and then you put and you download application form in there. Okay. And after that, you already got the application form. You can go through going to our website, Tianjin University registration website, and apply for pre-admission letter through ISSS website. This is tgu@0089.cn/student, and get pre-admission letter. Once recommended by dispatching authorities as an eligible candidate, you will receive award letter from CGS candidate. This is compulsory, okay? And after you got pre-admission letter from Tianjin University, send all the relevant hard copy document, include application form from CGS, okay? Pre-admission letter from Tianjin University and other relevant material documents, like, for example, like medical checkup, your non-criminal record, your transcript, and then your high diploma certificate, like your study plan, also put on your in one map, one back there, and then you have to send to your Chinese embassy in your country, like that. If you are in Indonesia, maybe you can send to in embassy in China in Jakarta. But in other country, you can send your Chinese embassy in dispatching authorities in your home countries. And after that, you only waiting further information from Chinese embassy. Okay, so you don't need to ask when we will get the information, how our results, no need. You just waiting for information from Chinese embassy, and then they will send you email. Either you will get in get interview or not, or maybe no need interview, just waiting, because they will be give information through your email. Okay, because I have friend, she already use this type, and then already send all her document, and then she just waiting, and then and she said like, I will have interview, because she is master, apply for master degree, right? She will, okay, you will get interview in this date, this like they will have certain like for example, like in early in May or early in June, like that, because like only Chinese embassy can know when we'll get certificate, the interview time, and then for the result should be in the end of July, okay, May 31 of July in each year, okay. And for type A, okay, this is I said before, you need to apply for pre-admission letter. So when you already put this website, ISSS, you can find this type, and then you have to choose pre-admission. Clear? Okay. And then for type B, okay. For type B is have a new rules. It's new rules. Okay, for new rules, it's same. Plan for new and old. For new, you have to apply through Chinese government scholarship, type B, and through CGSI, it's same. Like this is website, and then after that, you have to download the CAC application form, and then after, you have to save it become PDF, and also now next step, you have to apply TGU application website through ISSS. ISSS website is tgu@0089.cs/student, and put all your documents, include CAC application form, then you submit it through ISSS. It's ISSS is a website when you want to apply to Tianjin University. Okay, after that, after the applicant submit on the step two, this step, application have to wait the you have to applicant wait the until the announcement if you get admitted or nominated or not. Okay, maybe this step you have to until 2 months or 1 month, you have to waiting of that, because then when you apply for a master, just have a interview part. Okay. After interview, in early June or in early July until the end of July, have a result if you got or not, you have admitted or nominated. If you already admitted, the Tianjin University will give you the pre-admission letter from Tianjin University. After that, you have to open the CGSI website again, this website, and then you have to upload your pre-admission letter to CAC website, means CGSI website, like that. And what is different with when you already admitted under step four, the Tianjin University will give you admission letter or acceptance letter through ISS system. So you will not upload the pre-admission letter. Only like that. Only that point the different you got admission letter, and in the new procedure and the old procedure, you will get admission letter or acceptance letter. And this new will be start in this year. So you guys have to attention of this new rules. Okay, this is only Chinese government scholarship type B Chinese university program. Okay, and this is for my admission in when you I applied for Chinese government scholarship in 2017, in when I bachelor degree. This is like a little different with like I already said before. I already prepare all my documents like medical examination, study plan, transcript, high school certificate, and others, and translate in English version. Okay, and send all documents to Tianjin University office by their email. Me only by email, and then waiting result from international office, and they give me the email the result. I will admitted or not, and then the university will send acceptance letter and GW201 to my home country, which means I from Indonesia. Okay, and then because after I got the acceptance letter and GW201, I can going to Tianjin University. And number, okay, sorry, this is number 7. Okay, for number 7, because I already have a China visa, so I can directly go to China, then re-registration. Because before in Tianjin University, I already studied in China for 1 year for Chinese language in Xiamen. It's in Huazhou University. So already my visa still valid, so I can directly going to Tianjin University without the have to some make a visa again. And then after I re-registration, I have to go to embassy. Not embassy, but same when you want to get a permit there in Tianjin, you have to go there. And then after that, it's finished. Only start the class as a first year student, and then after that I can survive in until my fourth year. And now I applied my last year I applied my master degree with all procedure, because I applied last year, really last year, and now have a new procedure like that. This is my step like this last year, and this is my bachelor degree when I applied my bachelor degree with CGS also. Okay, for interview experience part 2. Actually, when I apply for bachelor degree, I don't have any interview experience, but for master also I have a interview. Okay, interview, I only put the 2 points. This is the important. First, self-confidence. Okay, in interview process, the main thing is to be a confident person, not to hesitate when in answering, because like when you already we really nervous when you for example the teacher said, okay, can you introduce yourself and you can you explain your research plan, and in that time maybe you guys will be oh my god nervous, oh I forgot what I already write before in our study plan. So you have to calm down. No need to like, oh my god, nervous. And then you have to be confident when you answer. Okay, if there is some, even there have a grammar mistake, it's not a big problem. So just let it flow and then be confident even there's some mistake there. Okay, and for study plan, of course, for my last year, there's a need to ask some study plan maybe, and maybe your future, what you want to do. You have the important, you have to mastering the content your study plan, because maybe they will be asked your study plan, also maybe they will ask your future plan. Okay, so the important thing is to be able to master your content of the study plan, so make sure your study plan is read by yourself, not by others. Okay, so for me, For make a study plan, you have to make for me maybe 3 months or until 4 months is enough, and that you because the study plan must be read on your reason why student must be acceptance in that university, which means in the university like that, because like in other countries same, there will be a requirement that you have to make study plan, your own study plan, or maybe have a, because I heard like I already look in other country, they need a motivation letter is different with study plan. Then motivation letter, like a statement letter is different template like that, because but in the university we need to study plan, okay. And four, this is my tips. Who you maybe this is I think for the difficult part is you when we have to make the study plan. Okay, for tips for me when you want to make a study plan, write your academic background and your achievement in first part. Okay, after that, explain your main educational goals. Begin, you can talking about what you want to study, what you want study in the university, why you want to study there, and for maybe you can why you have to choose that major, why China like that. And then for in the third, explain why you choose the particular school or that program or program. It's enough to say what your school you want to study, nor is it enough to say a good school. Rather, you may maybe you need to provide your reason why you go to that school. Maybe you why you choose that professor like that. Okay. This is also important. You need to know what your future, what you want to do after you graduate. So in your study plan, you have to put your research plan, discuss your future research if you are a postgraduate student. For example, when you apply in master, you have to, okay, I will research, for example, you want to research renewable energy. Okay, what renewable energy? What's the future will be if you already doing your thesis there? And then if after I graduate, I will doing my PhD, or maybe I will doing my work with a company or B company like that. And you have to make some reason, a very big reason. So you have to improve your knowledge. Maybe you can go to webinar, or maybe you can read journal or read some website. You have to write that. You have to really know what's your major, your research in your future, and what you want to do. Really, really, really understand. Okay. And narrow your research to show you are serious. It means this is for PhD students, taken to many variables in their research. So you don't have to cover don't have to cover every aspect. Just narrow just on the important ones. Same. Master also, so you, maybe you guys really like, okay, really hesitate, like, okay, I have a 10 variables. Don't make like every aspect you have to explain, only maybe 2 or 3 variables you explain, the main variable. Okay, because they will be not read all, but they will be, okay, the important one, like that. Okay, and this is the last. It is important talking about how your study help your terms goal. Okay, I read not Chinese government scholarship, but in other country scholarship. If you already done your study, what's your contribution? What's your the last part you need to? What is your contribution after you studies in Tianjin University, or after your studies your program, and help to your country, maybe help your goals, your long-term goals like that. You have to write that. It's important. Okay. You can take note for this. Once you establish what your immediate goals, discuss how you see the program helping you or your country with your future goals. That way, the scholarship committee has a better idea of who you are and why you are picking your particular major, school, and location like that. So this is you have to research how your study will help you. Okay, this is you have to take note, or maybe you can screenshot, or maybe you can take a photo for these tips. Okay, Okay. Part four. This is only sharing because at 2016 I start going to China to study Chinese language first for 1 year, but not 1 year, but only 8 months. I've got SSK5 there, and then I applied in Tianjin University with environmental science major in Chinese Town, and now I also as a master student in Tianjin University with English Town, because I applied in Chinese Town, but international office said that I have to choose in English, because when you still want this major, you have this major with this scholarship, you have to change in English. But it's okay. It's some new challenge for me. This challenge for me. And then 3 words for study in China first. Because this is not your country, not this. Maybe it's not your this not your country. You have to work hard. Okay, you have to work hard. Especially when you in Chinese South. In Chinese South, it's. I think for me, it's a little bit difficult, because when you study Chinese language and you enter your major like science or engineering, you have a different like your the science. Like the how to say for example like oxygen or the physics like that. It's really I never learned before, but I just let it flow, and I have to more work hard than other student like that, and then it will be helps you to graduate in time. Okay, and number two, become a brilliant person, because you have to every day you have to have a good time management. You have to attend to your time management. You have to become still your study. Also, you have to become your have a social life like that. And you have to responsible with your study. It means you don't after you okay. I got scholarship. I got Tianjin University. So I can play anytime. I can play with others anytime. No, like that. You have to responsible study. So you have can graduate in time, because like you know, like maybe they so far from their parents, they will be okay, I'm free, I have a freedom. But you have to remember why you choose China, why you choose Tianjin University when you first time to apply. Okay, this is important. Okay. This is my journey there. This is my first year. I took a picture there. Also, this is, you know, it's just some funny there in dormitory. There, I have a family there, and then I took a picture with one of girls there. This girls. She really good friend. She waiting me. She waiting me in front door of me. It's, oh my god, it's really cute. Okay. And then this is I know my major is environmental science, but my professor, she know that I really interest with finance major, and she inviting me to join the webinar. No, not the seminar. In Faculty of Finance and Economics in University is really good experience for me. Okay. So this is you know, when I first time in there, I in Tianjin University, I really 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 big pressure, especially in first semester, and I just sharing like I almost crying in front of my professor, and then she said like, okay, you have to go holiday, you have to have time to your life. Okay, so I decide okay, tomorrow I will going to Shanghai with my friend. Like before I have a plan to go to Shanghai to Disneyland like in winter holiday, but I think I can wait to there. So I decide okay, I have to get a rest healing holiday there. So I just in almost 1 week there, okay, and after that I can focus on my study. It help you. You have sometimes you have to going somewhere with your friends and maybe 1 week for take a rest, take a break. Then it will help you. Okay, this is my friend there. He's from Indonesia. they is same with our same with our dormitory. Maybe you guys in here know them, know one of them. Okay, it is my celebrate my birthday. They give me surprise there also when weekend. We going to, you know, being Pingjiang Tao is what the city in Tianjin University. We Tianjin in Tianjin, and then we hang out there also. This is photo with the I forget, this is Mongolia. This is one of out Mongolia there. She's a beautiful woman and she's smart, and I have to take a bus to old campus because I have a class in old campus in the university. So I met her in a bus station. Okay, this is my birthday there, and they give me a cake and give me a present. Okay, also this is a Indonesian student in Tianjin. We have a dinner there. We take some dinner, and this is Mapocha, like the restaurant, one of them. Also, I take a really impression with Tianjin University. So I took a picture in Tianjin University. It was really beautiful. And okay, of course, this is library. Oh my God, it's a really big library. Almost like a mall. Really big, because they're almost all the students will study in library. I took a picture. Because I study from, okay, in this is I study from 8 a.m. until 10 p.m. in Tianjin University. Especially this is I start in second year and third year there in library. Also, this is my experiment class. I forgot what's experiment there, but of course it's experiment. Also, this is the last picture before I going back to my country, because we have a pandemic COVID-19, right? So I take a picture with a lot of snow there. It's really beautiful. I really miss my Tianjin University. Of course, you guys, if you guys outside in China, of course you will miss the Tianjin University, especially in winter. It's in winter. Okay. Okay. This is. I have I don't know, because the Tianjin University a really good university for me, and one of international office sent me message by WeChat, and she said my name Kezia, my Chinese name Meizhen, you know. I said she said like Meizhen, can you do you want to apply for this competition? It's a speech competition with Tianjin in local Tianjin University. Okay, so I take the competition, speech competition, introduction China, introduction my introduction my Chinese language, like that. Okay, and then oh my God, I win with honors awards. Okay, and after that, next year she invited me to join the competition. This is for next year is a more big competition. Of course, it's speech competition also, and we have to talk in Chinese like that, because it's all from Malaysia, me from Indonesia, and this is I forgot from where. I have from Russia also, a lot of country there. And oh my God, this is a really really good experience in Tianjin University, because Tianjin University really welcome for international student. Okay, this is my experience. And if you guys still want to get in touch with me and Timothy, you can you can contact us. This is my YouTube channel, Kizia Murli, and this is my Timothy Joseph Sagol, and my WeChat in Timothy WeChat. Or if you guys have Instagram, you can follow us to further information, because in our Instagram we have a next webinar what we will be do, and we have a YouTube and for talk show with a lot of country, and this is our LinkedIn if you want to know our background like that. Thank you so much, guys.